Grafana Case 6 version 1.0 is officially released. Hi, I'm Bacola, a senior developer advocate at Grafana. Over 8 years ago, Case 6 began as an open source project with a simple but powerful idea: helping developers prevent fires in production by safely starting controlled ones during the testing process. Since then, Case 6 has become a go-to for developers, QA engineers, and performance testers looking to create reliable, scalable tests without the overhead of handwriting every script. Case 6 makes it easy to go from idea to execution and allows you to produce clean, reusable testing code. Case 6 supports a wide variety of test cases, including high-load performance tests with spike, stress, and soak testing, browser-based testing to capture real user metrics and identify front-end performance issues, synthetic testing to continuously monitor your service performance. Today, we're marking a major milestone with the release of Case 6 version 1.0. This new release brings a wide range of new and exciting features. The first feature is clear support and semantic versioning guarantees, so you can test with confidence. The second feature is full TypeScript support, so you can write more robust and maintainable tests. The third feature is extension support, so you can extend Case 6 without extra tooling or custom builds. And finally, a completely revamped test summary that gives you deeper and more actionable insight at the end of every run. All these updates double down on our promise to make reliability testing predictable, scalable, and developer-friendly, whether you're simulating 10 users or 100,000 users. Let's take a closer look at what's new. Let's start with the first major update, which is that Case 6 now has clear support and versioning guarantees. Case 6 has always prioritized backwards compatibility. As the project grew, the need for well-defined boundaries became more important. With version 1.0, we formalized these boundaries so you can test with confidence. Here's what's included. First, Case 6 now follows semantic versioning. This means breaking changes will only happen in major releases like version 2.0 and always with clear deprecation warnings ahead of time. Second, Case 6 is committed to long-term support. Every major version will receive critical fixes for at least 2 years. So whether you stay on version 1.0 or choose to upgrade later, you'll have the stability and guidance you need. Third, we've defined a public API surface. If you're building or using extensions, you now have access to stable, well-documented Go modules. All these changes are documented in detail, and you can find the full breakdown in our updated documentation linked below in the description box. The next feature we're excited to announce is native TypeScript support. This was one of the most requested features from our community, and we are happy to deliver this update. With native TypeScript support, you can now write more robust and maintainable tests with full type safety, autocomplete, and improved developer experience. You'll also be able to reuse your existing TypeScript code and type directly in your Case 6 test. This makes it easier to integrate performance testing into your existing workflows. The next feature we're excited to announce is extension support for Case 6. In older versions, using extensions with Case 6 often required custom builds and external tooling. But with this version 1.0, that is no longer the case. You can now use Case 6 extensions or extend Case 6 itself without forking or a complex setup. Case 6 now supports importing a set of pre-approved extensions directly into your test. The feature is already available for tests ran in Grafana Cloud using Case 6 Cloud Run and Case 6 Run --local execution. And support for Case 6 will be rolled out in a future release. Let's walk through an example script that uses the Case 6 --x/faker extension. First, import the Case 6 --x/faker extension into your script. Next, we'll create a random name using the faker.person class. And finally, run your script as you normally would. As you can see, there is no need for dedicated tooling anymore. Another top request from the community that we've delivered on in this version 1.0 is a completely modernized end-of-test summary. This new summary includes scenario-specific metrics, group-specific metrics, hierarchical grouping of results, improved checks results, different levels of granularity of information collected and displayed. By default, Case 6 shows a compact view that surfaces the most important insights. But if you want more details, add the flag --summary-mode=full in K6 will walk through every layer of the test. The final updates are updates to stability and the quality of K6 core modules like K6/browser, K6/net/gRPC, and K6 crypto. These are all now stable. You can now stream local test results to Grafana Cloud using the command k6 run --local-execution. The K6 command has also been revamped to be more powerful and flexible and provide a richer integration with the Grafana Cloud K6 ecosystem. As we wrap up, I want to give a big thank you to the K6 community. Whether you contributed code, built extensions, filed issues, or simply advocated for K6 within your organization, this release wouldn't have been possible without you. If you're ready to get started with K6, head to k6.io/docs. There you'll find everything you need to dive in. Please see the link in the description box below. You can also explore the full release notes on our GitHub, and if you want to connect with others using K6, visit k6.io/community. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.